Hey guys, it's Haley, Cosmetology 120 Lab, and today we are going to do waxing of the brow and upper lip. So today we are going to start by greeting our client, escorting her to the work area. We are going to look at her current style, discuss her preferences, concerns, things like that. Then we are going to do a skin analysis. In the skin analysis, we're looking for skin that is irritated, inflamed, broken, raised, swollen in the area to be worked on. We are looking at skin that may have open wounds or sores. And we are looking at skin that may be infected or have an infestation, such as lice, that would stop us from performing the service safely today. If the client is good with all that, we're going to go ahead to the consultation form. And on the consultation form, we are going to discuss any medication or products the client has taken within the last 72 hours and any known allergies that the client may have. We're also going to discuss any facial surgeries they've had within the last 3 months and if they remain under a doctor's care for those, as well as if they are prone to fever blisters and or cold sores. We are also going to discuss if the client has used any exfoliants or skin lightening agents such as AHAs and BHAs within the last 72 hours or 3 days. And we are going to discuss if the client has had any facial injections such as Botox or hyaluronic fillers in the last 3 weeks. If the client is free from all of those, then we would proceed with today's service. So the first thing we're going to do is wash our hands. So washing my hands under warm running water and lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. We're going to rinse our hands under warm running water. And we're going to dry our hands with a disposable paper towel. We're going to turn off the water with the disposable paper towel and dispose of that in the trash. Then we are going to apply gloves. We are going to use our Barbicide wipes today, and these are EPA registered. They are verified as a fungicidal, viricidal, bactericidal agent approved for use in the spa and salon setting. So with wipe number one, we are wiping down our table, our work area. We're going to wipe down our wax warmer and our lamp if we're going to use one. And we are going to wipe down our cart as well. Our wiping down the tops of our single-use containers. And disposing of that in the trash. And then we have wipe number two, and this is actually disinfecting the area. And we would wait 2 minutes in between those. So we're going to wipe down our wax warmer, which should be warming up by now. Making sure that it's working effectively. Wipe down our lamp. And again, our cart. Tops of our single-use containers, etc. Disposing of that in the trash, and then we're going to take our gloves off. And these would be disposed of in the trash. And then we are going to gather the items that we're going to need today. So we are going to start by draping our table. So this would be disposable table paper. We have our tweezers and we have our wax sticks. We have some eye rounds. Wax strips as well. Wax strips. And then also have tissues. And I have all of my products. So post-epilation, wax remover, soothing gel, cornstarch powder, pre-epilation cleanser, and wax. Today we're using honey, so I'm going to start by filling all of those. That on the side of my table, and then we are going to assist our client onto the table, and we will roll a towel to put under her neck, and this is for comfort. She's going to get a hairnet. To protect her hair, and we're going to drape her with a drape across the chest just to protect the clothing from any wax that may spill. Client is ready to go, and we are going to go ahead and wash our hands again. So wetting our hands, washing them under warm running water with liquid antibacterial soap. putting our hands under warm running water, drying our hands with a disposable paper towel, turning off the water with the disposable paper towel and disposing of that in the trash, and then we are sanitizing our hands. Hand sanitizer has to be between 62 and 70% alcohol, and this particular product is 70%. To apply gloves. And we're going to start by cleansing. Direction of the hair growth. As well as the upper lip. Then we are going to apply some cornstarch powder. Is to give the skin a protective barrier as well as remove any moisture that may have remained in the area. Are going to test the wax wrist, allowing the wax to drip onto the wrist. Use a disposable mascara wand to guide the direction of the hair. Dispose of that. And then we're going to use our small scissors here to trim any hairs that are hanging over the put those in our to be disinfected. Wax in the direction of the hair growth. Apply applying a strip, pressing it to make sure that the wax comes through, holding the skin tight, quickly removing the strip, applying immediate pressure, and then removing any remaining wax. Tweezing any hairs that remained. to apply a soothing gel. are going to discuss maintenance and aftercare with the client. We laundered. Now, this will go into our to be laundered as well. These will be disposed of and the container will be disinfected. And then we are going to clean our workspace. So again, wipe number one with the Barbicide wipes is cleansing and sanitizing. We're wiping down lamp, wax warmer, all of our products. Wiping down everything again with wipe number two. This is our actual disinfection. Disposing of that in the trash, and again, all of this has to sit for 2 minutes in between and 2 minutes after. Disposing of our gloves, and we're going to wash our hands again. So, wetting our hands and applying liquid antibacterial soap. Rinsing our hands in warm running water. Drying our hands with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with the paper towel. Disposing of that paper towel in the trash. And then we are going to sanitize our hands. Again, this particular product is 70% ethyl alcohol.